Good morning, my children, and once again, welcome back to your English class, the class of the teacher Jacob. For today, my children, we're going to continue with sentences mixed with days of the week. Now remember, days of the week, it's part of the calendar. Now, for the calendar, remember, it's divided in three. We have days of the week, months of the year, and seasons of the year. Days of the week, we have 7 in total: Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Continuing with the second part, which is months of the year. We have January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, and December. And speaking about this final month of the year, remember that right now we are on the month of December and we are this close to have our Christmas festival. So it's very important that you continue practicing the Christmas songs, such as "We Wish You a Merry Christmas," "We Wish You a Merry Christmas," and the other song, "Rocking Around in the Christmas Tree." Now for this, we need musical instruments so our dance looks better. Recuerden, chicos, que estamos cerca de celebrar nuestro festival del Día de la Navidad, por lo tanto les pido mucho su apoyo para seguir repasando las canciones que vamos a cantar y bailar durante este festival. Recuerden que estas canciones son dos. Tenemos "We Wish You a Merry Christmas", donde ustedes nada más cantarán esta parte, yo cantaré el resto de la canción, y por supuesto "Rocking Around in the Christmas Tree". Para esta última canción la vamos a bailar junto con instrumentos musicales, ustedes que tengan en su casita, a lo mejor claveles, o a lo mejor unos cascabeles, o a lo mejor unos panderos, algo que ustedes tengan que sea rítmico para que nuestro baile sea mucho mejor. Now, continuing with the parts of the calendar, remember we continue with the last one, seasons of the year. For seasons of the year, we have 4 in total, starting with the spring, summer, autumn, and winter. Remember, spring, when the sun is very happy, when all the flowers, when all the grass, when all the leaves of the trees are completely shining, okay? And we have insects such as butterflies and beautiful bees. After that, we continue with summer. It's when we go out from vacation. For autumn, when the leaves of the trees start to fall down. Recuerden que en otoño las hojas de los árboles empiezan a caer, because it's the arrival of winter, porque es la llegada del invierno, okay, donde hace mucho frío y celebramos la Navidad. Now, for today, we're going to check 4 sentences. 2 of them appear on your teddy book. I will explain the activities of today in a few moments, but for today, let's concentrate, for right now, let's concentrate on the activities. Para el día de hoy, chicos, vamos a practicar y platicar acerca de 4 oraciones que vamos a mezclar junto con días de la semana. Ahora, 2 de estas oraciones son parte de sus actividades para el día de hoy. Las otras 2 oraciones yo las puse para que sigamos practicando este tema. Now, let's check the first sentence for days of the week, and it says, she, remember, she, it's a pronoun for girl. In Spanish, ella. Don't forget to review pronouns and the verb to be. Recuerden, chicos, que ahorita que ya vamos a salir de vacaciones, aparte de que ustedes se relajen, descansen, se la pasen increíble, pues también de vez en cuando dedíquenle unos 5 minutitos a la clase de inglés, al repaso de todos los temas que hemos visto, incluyendo los pronombres. So, she, in Spanish, ella, she plays the piano, plays the piano, plays, toca, She plays the piano on Wednesdays. She plays the piano on Wednesdays. Ella toca el piano los miércoles. Very good. Number two, it says, we. Remember, we for a specific group of people in which the person that is pointing and is speaking is also in that group. Nosotros. Okay? We go, vamos, go to a baseball game on Thursday. Now, baseball, it's a sport. Remember, the baseball, it's the one that requires a bat so we can hit the ball. Okay? So, once again, we go to a baseball game on Thursday. Nosotros vamos a un juego de baseball los jueves. Okay? Let's continue with the additional sentences that I wrote for you. Vamos con las oraciones adicionales que preparé para ustedes. It says, Carlos, the name of a boy. Now remember, for sentences, we can also use the name of a person. Okay, there is no problem. We can use pronoun or the name of the boy or the girl. Recuerden que para las oraciones, nosotros también podemos utilizar los nombres de las personas, no nada más pronombres. Si ponemos o utilizamos el nombre de un chico o de una niña, no hay ningún problema, sigue estando correcta la oración. Carlos, the name of a boy, Carlos practices karate. Remember, karate, it's a discipline. Karate on Mondays. So, Carlos practices karate on Mondays. Carlos practica karate. Recuerden que el karate también es un deporte. Los lunes. And finally, the last sentence, it says, Carla, the name of a girl, Carla dances ballet, dances, baila, dances ballet every Sunday. Todos los domingos. Carla dances ballet every Sunday. Carla baila ballet todos los domingos. Okay, now, before I explain the activities of your teddy book, let's practice our pronunciation exercise for these four sentences. Remember, I say it first, repeat after me with all of your energy. Vamos a practicar nuestro ejercicio de pronunciación. Para esto, recuerden, quiero escuchar a todos después de mí para que de esa forma pueda yo escuchar y saber si lo hicieron correcto. Empezamos with the number one. It says, she plays the piano on Wednesday. Very good. Ella toca el piano los miércoles. Number two, we go to a baseball game on Thursday. Nosotros vamos a un juego de béisbol el jueves. Number three. Carlos practices karate on Mondays. Carlos practica karate los lunes. And finally, Carla dances ballet every Sunday. Carla baila ballet todos los domingos. Excellent. Now, the activities of your teddy book, my children, appeared right here on this page. page 103, we have two sentences, the one about playing the piano and the one about the baseball game. So, you know, the instructions, we only have to copy it one time each sentence. Remember, the important part of this activity is we have to copy correctly. Remember, they are words that need two squares, vertical form or horizontal form. Most of them use only one, and remember also to leave spaces. Recuerden, lo importante de estas actividades, chicos, es respetar los espacios que nos indica cada palabra, cada letra. La mayoría de todas las letras requieren un cuadrado. Hay letras que requieren de dos cuadrados, ya sea en forma vertical, parada, o en forma horizontal, acostada. También no se les olvide dejar espacios. Okay? That's it for today. Only one page. Una página nada más. So, remember, we are this close to celebrate our Christmas festival, so I implore you to continue practicing the songs that I gave you. So, until that day, we see you tomorrow with more information, more activities, more parts of the calendar, more reviews. Have an excellent day. Take care. Goodbye.